And you guys make your way to the outside of the Diamond Nest Tavern. The front doors are open, and you can hear from the inside the laughter, bustle, and movement of people and music playing very loudly from the interior. You see across the way, there's a live band playing. For Scanlan, you do recognize two of the individuals on the far side of the bar. Rowdy-looking but well-dressed half-orc violinist named Dr. Dranzel.
Oh, yeah!
It's my troupe.
This is amazing.
It's my troupe.
How about you ask to jump in for a tune?
Yeah, you know, we never get to see you play, Scanlan. Not to your full capacity.
We'll blend in.
I plant my foot firmly into his ass and just shove him towards the two guys.
You're shoved forward, stumbling, almost being tripped by a few of the patrons, but as you stop and look up, you see before you a young, cute, gnomish girl with very short pixie brown hair, currently playing the flute. She kind of looks over at you and gives you kind of a winky grin. But behind them all, towering over just by stature, is Dr. Dranzel with his violin. And as you stumble forward, he looks over and just kind of gives you a smile and keeps playing.
Mind if I jump in?
It would be an honor.
Hey!
Scanlan Shorthalt, ladies and gentlemen, jump into the fray.
I get the flute. I'm gonna play the flute for a while.
So you pull out your flute, and the other gnomish girl with her flute as well kind of gives you a look, and you guys start weaving together this kind of like flute duel, almost like Flight of the Bumblebees, but two conflicting sides. As the song builds, people are cheering and shouting, and you bring the drinks over, Keyleth, and you kind of set them down.
Can me and the other flutist end with an impossibly long-held note?
Make another perform check.
33.
Yeah!
And with that, you both inhale almost like through eye contact. You know what's coming? And you both just hold and hold, and you can see her eyes start to get tense and bloodshot. Her face starts turning beet red. All the rest of the music stops, and everyone just kind of gathers around. The air leaves the room as everyone seems to kind of lean in, and eventually, she gives up and exhales and inhales sharply, dizzied by it but still smiling. And you can only imagine the blurred romantic tunnel vision she has in your direction as you carry it for about 3 seconds more, and then end with a trill at the end. As you kind of, it's been a while since you've done a performance of this magnitude, and it makes you feel good. And at that point, you feel a hand clasp your shoulder, and Dr. Dranzel leans in.
It's good to see you again, Shorthalt. It's been a while.
Yes, it has, sir. Yes, it has.
Haven't lost your edge. Come, drink, eat with us.
Kaylie, that was some fine playing. I might have a tip or two about breath control.
Sorry, not all of us are quite as old and seasoned as the others.
Well, I've learned quite.
I've
learned quite a thing or two in my years, and it might interest you to take a little private tutoring session sometime.
Scanlan Shorthalt, you know I've heard quite a bit about you.
My legend has spread far and wide, I'm sure.
Indeed, and I know better than most ladies that may cross your path.
You may change your tune.
I will. The man, the myth, and the legend is true. So, in case you wanted to find out.
she gives you a look over.
A holy woman?
Oh, shit.
She's got holes in all the right places. Oh! Doing here.
She actually, at that point, goes, turns around,
Doctor, you weren't kidding.
This one's certainly a card, and she gives you a wink and passes a drink your way across the table.
Wow, that was cool.
I like this girl.
Well, so the company you're keeping seems to be formidable.
We are.
What do you do? What's your trade? What do you... tugging around with sap for.
They're powerful warriors, killers, assassins, magic wielders. Pretty amazing people, and we've had quite a few adventures in the past few years.
So, Scanlan's a kingslayer. It's true.
He might not believe you or really anything about me. I walk over to Kaylie, and I say, my dear Kaylie, I'm sorry if we got off on a weird foot. I have that effect on people sometimes. Especially...
Your feet are weird. That's interesting.
Especially lovely to look at, young ladies. Ah, you are
smaller
quite
than I expected, those feet.
Well, you know what they say.
I do.
Wait, no, don't.
I know what they say.
No, don't. That's not what... Anyway, I was impressed with you up there. Your skills with the flute are remarkable. I was wondering if I could have a little fun tonight and challenge you to a flute off. If you win, I'll give you whatever's in my purse.
Fucking bad cap.
And if I win, I get a kiss.
Somehow I think I'm still getting the shit end of the deal.
Yes.
But I'm one for fun at the very least.
Right.
It's a deal.
No, don't worry.
Kitchen.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the first ever flout off.
Get into the kitchen.
Flutist off. Right. Flute duel. Featuring me, Scanlan Shorthalt, and you, Kaylee.
Kaylee's fine.
Kaylee's fine, everyone.
Sure. And as the band picks up behind you.
Come on, Dr. Dra.
Dr. Dranzel picks up his instruments, and you guys start playing back and forth with your flutes, just picking off, improvising off of the classic. Kaylee is trying to keep up, and you can see her face starting to go red. She's determined on this, and she keeps continuing with pushing this into an improvisational flurry of notes that completely walks around your performance previously done.
Oh, shit.
You find yourself having to take a step back as she begins stepping up onto the table, and now, even at her gnomish height, is looking over the entire crowd as people who previously were not as interested are starting to turn around and look towards you two playing.
I can't be one-upped. I use minor illusion to create sort of a mirror image of myself over myself, also playing the flute.
And you and Kaylee are facing off, looking directly at each other, furiously going on your flutes.
Just blowing at each other.
Eyes locked, tapping your feet heavily against the actual wood of the table, which is a boof, boof. You both take one deep breath and go for that same sustained note a second time. She's challenging you at the game she lost last time.
Yes. It's a 22, but I'm gonna let her win.
You can see she's starting to already go a little blue in the face, determined to win this, and she's about to falter. You could win this if you want to, but are you going to let her?
With a wink, I end my note.
As the flute leaves your lips and you go into a fake gasp of air, she finishes on a high, piercing tune, a trill, and then finishes off, carrying the flute away with a smile as your illusion fades and the crowd continues.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kaylee's fine! Ladies and
you're good. But I'm better.
I just tip my hat to her and say, yes, ma'am, it seems that tonight you are. Alright, I kick her, I don't know, what am I? I kick her 100 gold.
What?
Excuse me?
You said your purse? No, your purse. You bet your purse.
I mean, that was a figure of speech, right?
You totally let her win, and you're gonna give her all your money?
He forgot about that part.
Drunk, he's drunk.
We should
he forgot about it.
Spitting it.
Looks over to Dranzel. Dranzel goes,
I did hear you say a full purse.
Oh, I hope there's so much money in that bag.
He forgot about it.
My dear, a deal is a deal.
The things you do for
do
women.
Do not give her your money.
Hand it over to
you. Take any
Kim.
Of the gold out secretly before you hand it over to
not
us?
There.
Such a life lesson.
All right. How much was in there?
2,600.
Oh!
She takes the change purse. It's a lot of coin.
Yeah, I get around a lot.
Have yourself a drink later.
And she steps off the table.
I tell them, I'll catch up, guys. I have to say goodbye to my mates.
Hurry.
Yeah. Your band with Dr. Dressel, they're all gathered together and they're finishing up their drinks and it looks like they're ready to go ahead and find their way out on the town for the evening.
Just wanted to say it was wonderful running into you. Well, our paths may cross again, and if you know or can ask around where Grayskull Keep is, come pay us a visit.
See you at your keep.
And I turn to, what is her name, Kaylee?
Kaylee, who is already behind you. Oh. And as you turn, she goes,
Grayskull Keep, is it?
Yes, it is. My room's on the second floor.
All right.
Playing a long game
on it. Such a pimp.
You guys make your way back to Grayskull Keep. As you approach the front gate of your establishment, you see Cordell and Shane are keeping their evening watch over the gate.
You've got guests waiting for you.
Oh, shit.
What? Who is it?
It's a bunch of them.
Oh, it's my friends! This is why I wanted to come home!
Jeez!
Scanlan! Finally!
Lovely to see you.
You can see now there's like three bottles of wine that have been drinking that are open and about.
Did you bring those?
Oh, no!
Tomorrow we'll set off to do this. In the meantime, we invite you to stay at our keep.
Yep.
Drink of our wine, eat of our food.
Yeah, more wine.
Please, make yourselves at home.
Yeah.
By comparison. Have one room in addition to what we stay in. Would all of you be staying in the same one? Or would you want to stay in the temple?
We have a couple of rooms.
I'll stay in the dungeon. They can stay in my room.
I have a rather large bed if Kaylee would like to take that. I could sleep on the floor. That's
you fine. Invited them to stay because you want to bone Kaylee?
Well, are you really cock-blocking
right
say now?
That out loud.
Are you cock-blocking in the keep?
As you're saying this, Kaylee's just watching this with a smirk on her face.
Well, I'm not one to turn down a soft bed for an evening.
Yeah, can't wreck that game.
Good luck.
The couple rooms are kind of crowded up with the other folks, except for Kaylee, who is following you, Scanlan, with a bottle of wine and two glasses.
Oh, my.
Oh, dear.
She's going to rob you blind.
Kaylee pulls out the chair and the table in the far end of the bedroom. Sits down against a pour glasses of wine and sits across. She asks you about your history and kind of your travels and how you met Hunter Dransel and everything.
I tell her all the best parts and leave out the naughty bit.
Interesting
Kingslayer.
Right.
Leader of a rebellion, you know.
So you've said a number of times.
She kind of drinks a little bit more of the wine, sits it down.
I guess I should tell you a bit about myself then.
Yes, please. I'm fascinated.
Well, I grew up in Kaimal, mostly, before moving to Westruun to train at the College of the White Duke. Finest of the bards, he was.
Yes.
Mom gave all her savings to put me up there. To be perfectly honest up front, I've already heard a bit about your tale of Shorthalt. The charming of the Pauper Prince, your rendition of the Summer Sunder at the Cliffs of Dagger Bay. I've been hoping our paths would cross.
Well, I'm flattered and, you have quite talent for quite a lot of talent for just having played with the troop for 6 months. I was impressed back there.
Thank you very much. You know, I've heard most of these stories. My mother, Sybil.
Who?
Sybil, a fine gnomish lass. She was some years ago with us. She came across a smooth silver-tongued flautist who blew through like the wind and disappeared. Took her innocence with a promise, then vanished just as suddenly. Left her a child to raise on the income of a quilter, she did. Now, growing up, I hear tale and tale of your musical feats, as my mother took on a third job
to
support us. A few bad harvests just south of Silvercut. Being the only tiny female fair folk in such a rural town means being preyed upon, so I learned to use a blade quickly and to wield my charm just as viciously. It seems that runs in the family, eh? I practiced. I stole. Lied about my age and eventually paid my way into the Duke's College so I can find you. Prove you a scoundrel. At this point, you see her stand up. She begins to draw a small blade from her side.
She's gonna fight me. Oh my god!
Her face is hardened and still as she stares at you. You see a slight tremble in her hand.
This day, Scanlan Shorthalt, I beat you at your own song. Now I come to take your dignity. Now take up your sword.
First of all, Kaylee. It's so wonderful to meet you.
Don't try it on me.
No! Listen, I have my faults, for sure, but I didn't know that you existed. I would have come to visit, I would have come to meet you. How can you fault me for something that I did not know about?
Do you even remember Sybil?
I mean, could you describe her a little more detailed? 16.
Vaguely recall Sybil. Golden hair. Very eager to escape her simple beginnings, and very clingy very quickly. You jumped out of there very fast,
Level
from
five.
Your perspective.
Ah, yes, Sybil. She was passionate, intelligent. Yeah. Really, a lot of handsy sort of. I mean, I think I remember her quite well, and she was a wonderful person, and you should be honored to have such a wonderful person as your parent, and not someone like me, because I was a scoundrel, you're right.
You are a scoundrel.
I have been, in past moments in my life, a scoundrel.
Do you even realize you nearly invited your daughter up to sleep with you?
I mean...
You don't
like
care.
I wouldn't have let it go that far.
You have no boundaries. You take what you like and you keep walking on. You trick folk. Now draw your blade.
I don't want to fight you, if that's what you're insinuating. Listen, I know that I've made mistakes in my life. I've admitted as much before, and I don't know why I'm this way. I must need to do a lot of soul searching to come up with an answer, but there is a woman who I love very dearly and who I would do anything for, and I'm trying to be a better person. I haven't been to a whorehouse in months. That's a big step for me. Big step. I know that sounds callous and cruel. If you're here to fight me, I'm afraid you're going to be terribly disappointed. Because I will just let you kill me, if that's what it takes. I didn't know you existed, and my heart is breaking 100 times now for not knowing it. Every year that you've been alive is a year I could have been a better person, and known someone who could have made me a better person, and I'm only sorry that I didn't know it. If there's anything I can do for you from now on, if you are truly my blood, I will, because among my many faults, ego is certainly one of them, and knowing you're part of me makes me love you even more.
Make a persuasion check.
32.
Oh. No shit, it won't matter.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
She's big. Too. She's big.
As she stands there with her blade out, kind of staring at you, you can see like the veins in her neck tensing.
I slowly unbutton my shirt and show her my chest and say, stab me right here if you'd like, and I will not resist. You've earned it, take me.
You see the tear begin to roll down her cheek as her jaw clenches. And she thrusts forward. And rolls a natural one.
A natural one?
Oh, a natural one.
As she goes to strike towards you, even in that moment, her will falters, and the blade just falls limp. And as the hand releases her weapon, it clatters to the ground as her momentum carries her arms around her shoulders.
Why? Why can't I do it? All the years building up to this, and I have the chance, and I can't do it.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry that you're going through this, and I'm more sorry that you're going through this by yourself. But I think deep down, you're a Shorthalt. And there's something that you have that's connected to me and I to you. And perhaps I misread that as some sort of icky attraction, and I apologize. But I've known for a while now that something is missing in my life, some sort of focus and some sort of moral compass. And maybe it's just arrived at my doorstep.
And she begins to walk for the door. And she opens the door and looks back at you and goes, her eyes kind of finally meeting yours, and
still a scoundrel. That's what's kept you alive this long. In some ways, it's what's kept me alive this long. I've got a lot to think about. I'm gonna go for a walk. I need some fresh air.
And she closes the door behind her.
I just sit for a moment and think about everything. Try to remember more about Sybil.
It's a lot of faces blurring.
Yeah.
You worked your way through a lot of Tal'Dorei in those days. You. Yeah, you
did. I have a very restless night thinking about everything in my room.
Okay. Nevertheless, all of you come down. Scanlan, you eventually come out of your confused reverie. Kaylie never came back throughout the night.
Is Dr. Dranzel around?
Yeah, as you head down to the main dining area, Dranzel's there, and he's a little hungover himself and enjoying the remnants of his meal.
Did you know?
About?
Did you know about the girl?
What did she do? If she's done anything wrong, let me know. She's part of my troop. I take responsibility for it.
No, she's a fine player and a fine, upstanding person, and you should take special interest in her. She's a good one. Just please, if she continues on with your troop, take good care of her, all right?
Of course.
How was last night, huh? Pretty wild. Thank God the walls were made of stone.
Let's just say I struck out, all right?
You? Yeah. Struck out?
It's fine.
Maybe I should have a go at her then.
No. She doesn't like our kind. She's off limits.
Oh.
Right? I saw her first.
You can't call dibs.
Wait. Are you in love?
Yes, you could say so.
Aww. Holy shit.
Can I inside check him?
Were you being honest?
I think maybe.
Yeah. No, Scanlan seemed pretty honest, if guarded.
Okay.
You return to Grayskull Keep. Drenzel, that whole team is gone, except for Zed.
The drummer?
Yes. Zed is currently having a little bit of ale in the dining room area, along with Jarrett, who is assigned to watch over Walther at the Keep.
Ah, you've returned. Good to see all of you in good health. The rest have left into the city.
Did they say why? For a performance?
Zed kind of leans forward and goes,
Actually, it appears that Kaylee got in some sort of a serious bar tussle last night and is currently being held in the stocks. He takes a sip of his ale. The rest of the troop's going to see if they can get her out.
All right, good to know. Thanks, Zed.
She's in the stockade. Only problem is getting caught. I like her style. Should we get her out?
I'd like to very much.
Well, Nina, it sounds like they're sending other people to get her out. What's the big deal?
They could make the problem worse.
Those guys? They'll make it worse.
She's quite special to me. I think I should go and try to get her out.
She's quite special to you.
There's one place I haven't done it, it's in a prison.
Okay. Not in that way. Okay, that's creepy. No, not in that way. I'm not interested in her in that way.
But you were courting her like 2 days ago.
Things have changed.
I thought she spent the night in your room.
She's a good person, and she.
Oh, we can win.
She deserves much better than the likes of me.
That's never stopped you before.
That's true.
Listen, all right. We're related. We're related.
What?
And I don't just mean.
Wait, what?
She's a Shorthalt.
Like a cousin?
Like a sister?
Like an aunt?
Like a mother.
like a baby. Like a baby's Shorthalt.
Whose baby?
Listen, don't spread the word around. I don't want my cred to be ruined, but she's my little girl.
You're a baby daddy.
I didn't know this. This is new information. I'm still just adjusting to it.
There's no part of you that knew you had any children.
I mean, I always knew that that was a possibility in the trade I deal in.
Which is Ed breaks in and goes, indeed.
All right, easy.
Wow. Well, that's
Yes, I don't quite know how to act or behave now, and I'm going through a crisis of conscience and identity, and I'm sorry. I'm off my game right now, but she's related to me.
Just make sure that she knows that you love her, and make sure that she knows that you're there for her.
Why do you keep saying she's related to you? Why don't you just call her exactly what she is, which is your daughter?
Okay, all right.
That's weird to be like, my child is related to me.
I'm not good with this stuff. I haven't done this before, all right? I haven't really had family for much of my life, and this is a new thing, and it's going to take me some time to adjust and figure out what this means for me, all right?
A redefinition.
You can make a really good move of it. by helping her get out of a stockade.
Yeah,
I would like to.
That's true.
You make your way towards the promenade stockade.
Scanlan, good thing you're here. I think we may need your silver tongue to go ahead and help us out in this endeavor. Dr. Drenzel's inside. He's been arguing with the warden for quite some time. We're trying to get Kaylie out.
What happened? Why is she in jail?
She got in a bit of a bar fight last night, it seems. Messed up quite a few gentlemen, and all of them are arrested and being held inside. Ours wouldn't let us.
Was she injured in any way?
I haven't seen her. I'll have to go inside to find out.
Do we know what happened?
The dog has teeth. Three against one. The stories say true, the bar patrons and the owner of the establishment all verified that she indeed started and finished it.
I don't care who started or finished it.
Warden.
Musician.
This is just like this bastard. He always goes around trying to boss people around and throw his money around, and I turn and I punch Percy in the face.
Whack! A solid hit across the face. You have to kind of lean into it and make it look more impactful than it really is.
Oh! And then I turn around and I punch a guard.
Oh my god.
You are put in shackles, brought and thrown into the same jail cell as Kaylie.
Aww.
You're thrown, you hit the ground, you can see off in the corner of the cell, Kaylie, arms crossed, sitting on the ground. She kind of leans forward a little bit, and you can see the light kind of hits the side of her face, and she has a bit of a welt there and a bit of a black eye, but she doesn't look too worse for wear. Leans forward to his,
Like father, like daughter, eh?
You could say so. I heard you had quite a night last night at the bar.
Felt good. Like breaking faces.
Apparently you're very good at it. I saw, got a glimpse of your victims over there.
They had it coming. Don't know why, but I had a feeling somewhere in their life, they probably deserved it.
Most men do.
Yeah, you're right about that. Stay away from all men. Listen, I've come to get you out of here.
Apparently he's not done that very well.
Don't worry, I've still got some tricks up my sleeve. Just wanted to make sure you're all right. Did they hurt you in any way?
Only one person's really hurt me recently.
Look, Scanlan. Father, I've spent a lifetime hating you. I'd imagined the moment we would finally meet for so long. Planned it out in my head. It all worked out. My idea of you. What you'd be like. What you'd say. And you know what? Up until last night, I was pretty spot on. I don't know what I wanted. I have a lot to process. But I prefer not to do it in this dang cell. So if you have a way out, please, now's the time to do it.
I'll need a distraction. Do you think you can come up with one?
I think that can be done.
She kind of leans up to the side of the bar and peeks her head out for a second. Closes her mouth, cups it with her hand. And you start hearing from the opposite side of the room, through arcane ventriloquism, these three different male voices going, "Oh, fuck yeah!" And you hear punches, and you hear like all this screaming and chaos, at which point the two guards kind of look over. One of them gives the other notion, and they both kind of run off to see the other side of the room. She looks back at you.
You'll have to teach me that trick. And then I dimension door us out onto the street.
As you reach for her, she still pulls away a little bit, but you still grab a hold and
do so.
Eventually, you guys make your way back. As you do, you gather, and about 5 minutes behind you, the rest of Dr. Dranzel's troop arrives, kind of looking a bit frazzled and a little confused, and he kind of steps forward to the rest of you and goes,
I don't know what you did, but there's a manhunt for two gnomes right now over by the promenade. But good on you. I want to lay low for a little bit.
Good thinking.
Our troop may want to get out of town for a bit as well.
I think that's the plan. Everyone feeling spectacular?
Claps his hands, and the rest of the troops start grabbing their goods and their instruments and what little cases and bags they do. And Kaylie runs off real fast and comes back with her one kind of over-the-shoulder satchel that carries all of her worldly belongings,
including all your gold.
Then, let us be off.
He gives you a little tip of the hat to Scanlan with a nod. Looks at the rest of you.
We greatly appreciate your hospitality.
Turns around, they all start walking out. Kaylie begins stepping, and she kind of stops and looks over her shoulder towards you, Scanlan, and says,
"Don't come looking for me. When I'm ready, I'll come find you."
turns back around and leaves.
Oh, shit.
Can I swing by Gilmore's and just see if he or Sherry works there?
Sherry works there.
Sherry works there, see if they're around.
What business did you have?
I just wondered. I may want to try to find someone at some point, and I don't know how.
Scrying. We've had this conversation before.
Yes, but a different sort, a less fecal sort.
As you appear, kind of catching your breath, you look over your shoulder and you hear in the distance more couple yells, like, and a bell starts going off. Ding, 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 in the center of the town square.
No, bell is bad, but he's in trouble. We need to go in now.
I'm going to go again, dimension door into the temple.
Okay, you do see the temple. You're on the interior of it now, and looking in there as you appear, if you look around and you hear a series of gasps. As you can now see huddled inside of this temple, roughly 30 or so people, varying ages, varying racial backgrounds. These are some of the survivors in Western that are keeping in here, whether it be hidden or at least this is where they live now. A few of them draw weapons immediately, and turning around, you see hunkered down inside a half-orc that rushes around, his hat half-kilter, spins around, puts his blade out.
You gotta be kidding me. Scanlan Shorthalt.
That's me.
As Dr. Dranzel stands up, they themselves look a little worse for wear, and he looks over his shoulder and says,
"Why am I here?"
Well, shit, Kaylee, weren't you just talking about him yesterday?
Oh, shit!
As your daughter stands behind him, kind of like holding two of the children, trying to protect him as you appeared, she looks up at you and goes, "Oh, you gotta be kidding me." Kaylee rolling her eyes, apparently unable to really escape through fate. Though there is a look, a brief glance of appreciation that at least you're not burnt to a crisp somewhere outside of Iman. But Dranzel walks up to you and is like, as hushed as he can be,
Scanlan, oh, so glad to see that you survived. What are you doing here?
We have a bit of a problem. See, my friends are stationed outside the main gate, lying in wait for these Goliaths that are terrorizing the town. My mission was to come in here and somehow convince the Goliaths to leave through the main gate, and my mission is not complete, and I'm afraid, well, I've roused them, and they're going to come in here and kill us all unless I get them out through the main gate. So, we're in a bit of a time crunch. Hi. And Doctor, you are such a long friend of mine and a trusted companion, but I'm afraid, though I love you, you cannot help me. I need Kaylee's help in this.
Kaylee kind of steps up now and brushes off her shoulder.
All right. So what kind of business am I getting you out of now, Father?
Well, not just getting me out of. I'm afraid we'll all die if you don't help.
Great, that's fantastic.
I'm sorry.
You've just banished all of these fine folks to their demise.
No,
I feel
not,
good.
No, I haven't. Not if you help. So, listen, I've been thinking a lot about you, and it's so wonderful to see you, and I just need you to trust me in this and lend me your talents and your magic if you can. Will you trust me today?
It doesn't seem like I really have much of a choice.
At which point you hear on the outside footfalls, heavy footfalls, going in the street on the outside of the temple, and you hear some shouting muffled in the distance. There's a moment of pause, and the door begins to push open against all the rocks and this barricade that's been placed against the door.
Shit. Can I grab Kaylee and get everyone to, is there anywhere to hide in this room? Okay. I'm going to very quickly, and with her help, usher everybody back into this back stair.
Okay.
Turn around, blow my horn of fog to fill the room partially with smoke.
Okay.
And then I'm going to tell Kaylee, can you throw your voice? I've seen you do it once,
I
right?
I can.
Can you change your voice?
I can.
Okay. Can you be the scariest fucking voice you've ever done in your entire life? I will tell you what to say, I'll whisper it to you. You just be the voice, I will be the visuals, all right? I'm gonna create an image and you're going to talk out of it, all right?
All right, let's go.
Okay, so I will use just a minor illusion to create the head of Stonejaw Strongjaw.
Yes!
They both stop and just kind of go,
Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
The human's like, yeah. And there's just a moment of pause there, and Kaylee's looking at you like,
okay, really quick. Here's your motivation. You're a dead Goliath. You were killed in combat by one of your own, and you probably sound really scary and fucked up. Ready? Go.
And outside of this central illusion, you hear a voice come moving forward.
I
fuck yes.
Am Stonejaw Strongjaw, return from the realm of the dead.
Yes, yes, yes. That's good.
Turns to you.
Keep going, keep going. You're doing great. I love you. Okay.
The Goliath goes, sorry then. And steps out of the room. The guy with the scraggled beard, who you gather is of a different type of a tribal background than the Goliath, just kind of gleans an eye untrustingly.
Yeah, strong jaw, you say? How strong is that jaw of yours?
And it throws an axe towards it. Okay. Just passes through and clatters behind.
Okay. Quick, say, you idiot, I am but a projection.
You idiot! I am but a projection.
The real Stonejaw is currently outside the main gate, waiting for a battle of revenge against Zanror. Send him now.
Vengeance against Zanror!
Great, you're doing great!
Bring him now, or you all shall suffer.
That last part was improv. That was amazing, King.
Thank you, thank you.
Dr. Dranzel walks by.
To say you two made quite the team.
I would say that as well, yes, I would. Thank you, Kaylee. That was better than I could have ever done.
That's true. All right then, so we're getting people out of here. How are we gonna get the rest of these folks out?
I can get me and Kaylee out. Sneak, we could try to make a sneak for it. Are there sewers here?
Kaylee nods.
There are sewers, eh?
You know the way out of the city, don't you?
I can show you.
All right. Do you have weapons? Can you protect yourself? Are you okay?
I can protect myself. Don't worry, Scanlan.
I'm just worried. I have to worry about you. I will always be worried about you. I'm sorry.
And you'll always be disappointed to find that I can take care of myself.
No, I won't be disappointed at all. In fact, that makes me quite happy.
Good. Can we be off then?
Well, all right. Okay, as long as you're happy, I'm happy.
Right.
Listen, I'm sorry. It's just, I never get to see you, and I know we're in a rush here and everything. You can't hate away me being your father, all right? I will always be the guy. No matter how much you curse my name and wish I was not part of you, my blood is inside of you, and I'm sorry, people, but, you know, I care about you, all right?
All right. It's not going to stop me from trying to hate you away, but I get what you're saying.
Well, go,
and they all start climbing in. Dranzel and Kaylee helping get the peasants down inside first. At which point,
go, go! I don't know the ways through the sewers. You have to go lead them, not me.
You guys quickly go, dart in. As you all jump inside, Dranzel grabs the grate top, gets down behind, and
right before he closes it, I step out. I step out and I say, "Take them to safety. Bring them outside the city. Hide. Stay safe."
Let's have a group training session, you guys.
Group workout?
To the danger room!
Wait, this is fun. Before we go. I wanna go find my daughter. I've gotta leave, sorry, bye.
Wait, what? Bye. What? You're just leaving?
Yeah, I gotta go, sorry.
Just like that?
Yeah.
We gotta talk.
Do you want help?
Yeah, I do. I'd like Fax to come.
Sure, buddy, sure.
Where are you going?
I'm going to where I dropped her off at the sewers.
Okay.
And I'm hoping that he can track or something.
Probably should have brought a ranger with you who's got a really good
I don't know what
you
can do.
You eventually find your way to a portion of the sewer to where a final grate that leads out into the night, because it is night at this point in time. It's a large, like 10-foot tall, circular grate. If you look, the bars are actually bent open. and it leads outward. The liquid from the sewage now spills out into this like small ravine on the very southern portion of Westron. You see the open plains southwestern.
No sign of tracks. Anyone huddled here for safety?
Looking around it, you can see a few footprints, scout footprints. You make a survival check. And nothing that specifically catches your attention.
I think she got out of here, pal.
Balls.
But she's not here.
That's true.
She's better off.
All right. Sorry, wild goose chase.
No, don't worry about it. You want to talk about it?
No. I just don't know when I'll see her again, so. I'll find her again. That's all.
I believe that too.
Yeah.
You guys begin to make your way from tents to tents, finding individuals, many of which you recognize. Some have recognition of you, and there's a brief little discussion of what's happened, what's transpired, and you tell them of the fall of Umbrasil, of the of the herd being sundered and sent westward, and making sure, as Scanlan would, that Vox Machina is responsible.
Yes, and that it rhymes.
Indeed, people are just kind of in this holding pattern, waiting to hear any news, and the news that you bring does bring hope to the eyes of those that do speak with you.
At some point in our journey, I excuse myself for 10 minutes, drink my last shit-scrying potion, poop out a little loaf, take a tiny bit of it. I take a tiny bit of it, wrap it in a little bit of parchment, stick it in the secret compartment of the sword, of the hilt of the sword.
Okay.
And I will also go to look for Dr. Dra and Kaylee at some point.
Go ahead and make an investigation check. Hunt, you see a glimmer of short, dark hair, and you glance over, and sure enough, there is Kaylee, who is currently holding over her shoulder Dr. Dranzel, who is kind of limping alongside her.
God. Oi, Shorthalt.
There's a stop, and Kaylee turns her head.
Hi.
She kind of drops Dranzel's arm and rushes forward and just gives you a hug. And then kind of lets go for a second, pushes away, and kind of.
I just see you survived. That's good.
You too? While she works on him, I'm going to just take Kaylee off to the side. I'm so happy that you're alive and safe. And I came a great distance to do other things, but mainly to see you, and I just wanted to say a few things before I go off to complete my mission. And, I know I'm not the father that you wanted, but I'm the father that you have, and I'm sorry. And I just wanted to tell you that, you know, I've been doing a lot of thinking about you and me and where I fit into the life of a family man and, well, most of my adult life, I've been longing for a gnome to care for, and I met a really good one, and she's here, and her name's Pike, and she's beautiful and wonderful, and possibly my soulmate, but I've learned that she's not my family and never will be, and you're the gnome that I'm to care for forever, and I'm doing something very stupid now with my friends. We're gonna try to save the world. And I didn't know why, but now I know. And if we die doing it, it will be for a good thing. And if we don't, then, well, I'll find you and I'll be whatever kind of father you need me to be, one who's close and helpful.
She shushes you, puts her finger up and shushes you. She steps up and looks you. The hardness in her face softens. And there is a little bit of tears gathering at the edge of her eyes, and she says, "Don't you die. You stay alive."
I don't intend to, but you know, I was just inside.
You're not going to die. You're gonna go do your stupid world-saving mission like you told me, and you're gonna come back, and we're gonna have a lot to talk about.
All right.
All right.
Can you do that for me?
I promise you.
I'll hold you to that.
I got you a present. It's a ring. It's a beautiful ring because you're a beautiful girl. And I'd like you to keep it.
She takes it and looks at it and goes,
"Are you sure this wasn't for someone else?"
"No, never."
She puts it on.
"And you're also strong, and you'll need this sword. And I give her my singing dawn blade, which has a unique little imperfection at the bottom of it. And I say, this sword has killed a king, which makes it almost worthy enough for you. And I hope that it keeps you safe until I can see you again."
I don't know what to say. I'll start with thank you. Well, I feel pretty well protected.
Okay, get out of here, if you can. Try to make your way to Vasselheim. There's 3 more dragons, and it'll be a while before I kill them all.
You promised.
Gnome's honor.
And she kind of reaches up and grabs your shirt and gives you a kiss in the forehead, and then pushes you away and says,
"Out of my fucking face."
Turns around and walks back towards Dr. Dranzel.
"All right, Pike, I'm done."
"Okay."
And they both kind of start walking away from you guys.
Before they go, I just reach up my hand and I've heard many lovely things about you.
She looks at you kind of guardedly and takes your hand.
"As I've heard of you." "He made a promise.
I'll make sure that he keeps it."
"Thank you." God damn this guy.
13 plus 10, he would have had disadvantage, but he has advantage against spell saves, so it just counts to a single roll.
Nothing's working. Pike is dead.
Unconscious.
Yeah, but I can't leave her.
Don't become another liability.
But if you move her, he'll get an attack of opportunity on her. It's what we ran into with...
The thing is, I've made a promise to stay alive, so I'm going to run away.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
That is Kima, Pike, Jamon, Scanlan, Vax, and Vex. I'll make constitution saving throws.
I rolled an 11.
An 11, yeah. So you take 43 points of cold damage.
I'm so dead.
No, unconscious.
Unconscious.
You're unconscious.
Negative 41.
Roll for... All right, that brings us to Scanlan.
"Business elsewhere, and you're being really obnoxious. Stay down."
And glancing over is going to go ahead and, with both of her hands again, release another cone of cold.
Oh no, this is going to be Scanlan.
Scanlan is
fucking damn it.
Frozen, covered in ice, locked in place. A solid gnome, bereft of life. Motionless on the ground.
I died as I lived. Hard.
Pike runs up. Is she going to be able to get her hand on Scanlan? So Pike puts her hands on either side of his face and says, "Scanlan, your letter to me was wonderful, and I want to do what you've asked, but I can't raise Kaylie alone. I need you to come back." And she casts Revivify on him.
Okay. The ice begins to turn to mist around him, and his color begins to return to his skin. His expression relaxes as his eyes suddenly focus, and Scanlan, you find yourself conscious again, looking up at Pike, tears in her eyes, pulling her hand back from your shoulder.
"Don't cry. I'm just a little cold."
"Warm up. Does anybody have a blanket?"
"Just hold me."
"Okay."
They just begin to walk perimeter as Pike joins up. And you are still left alone in the tunnel, should you be so inclined.
All right, I'll whip it out again. Oh, I'm taking another third, and I'm packing it in the front of the flute.
Please,
OD. Wow.
Okay. I need you to make a constitution saving throw. You guys watch as a singular male gnome ally is face down on the ground, not moving.
Scanlan? Smack him a couple times. Does he wake up?
Yeah, are there any signs around Scanlan as...
Well, yeah, there is the tarnished brass flute that was gifted to him by the leader of the foreign city of Ankarel that is currently tarnished by the use of its magic, and it is jammed packed with a black, ashy, crystalline substance with a trail of smoke that is kind of lazily drizzling off the tip.
Guys, I feel like this was a classic Scanlan.
you watch as Scanlan begins to shift and his eyes begin to flutter open, and you come back to consciousness with a mild headache, with all of your friends gathered around, and Keyleth and Vax with their hands in your pockets. Vax.
Get your hands out of my pockets.
What did you do? Face down.
I was shaken by today's events, and there was a lair action that knocked me unconscious.
Holy shit.
Insight check on him?
Sure. Scanlan, make a deception check.
32.
Where'd you get Keyleth?
22.
Legitimately, like, oh, I guess a misunderstanding.
I'm shaken, guys. I'm sorry. I'm not myself. Appreciate your concern, but yeah. What the fuck, Vax? Why did you just charge in after Raishan like that? Next time, will you please tell us?
There wasn't a lot of time there, Scanlan.
She was casting. She was reaching for whatever it is she's been angling for months.
Well, you almost got me fucking killed, all right?
Actually, you did get killed.
You died. Yeah. So did I. Death.
That's even worse than
what
almost
did you
being
think
killed.
We were... Pull out a piece of paper. Yeah? Shove it into your chest. That was for if I died. If you're gonna die, don't do it with a fucking flute up your ass, all right? I storm off.
In my room, I am... taking Vax's letter and ripping it in half and burning it. And I'm packing my pipe for the morning.
Okay.
I have to deal with this.
Serious. And even got hit. Scanlan got hit in there.
I was on the edge of one of them.
Balls. Yep.
Cone of cold?
Yes. Again.
What is that?
I
is
die.
That a wraith?
I am unconscious.
Fuck.
You're got the pot.
Why won't you all just stay down and die with dignity?
We don't do anything with dignity.
Scanlan's lifeless corpse has a pool of urine around it.
And one hit point.
Your hands are
just
covered
to get
in piss
you up.
Now.
Oh, that's fine.
You are conscious.
Are you up?
Is this covered? My urine? Someone else's?
Raishan, Scanlan, as you're on the ground, kind of getting your bearings back to consciousness, you watch as your head is across the ground, the rocks kind of. And something seems to hit the ground right next to you. Raishan's going to do a full round of just physical attacks on you.
Great. It won't take very much since I've got the one hit point. Mm-hmm. But
just,
I mean,
let's just call it.
Yeah, you're unconscious.
I'm unconscious.
Yes. Now, yeah. And the last final claw attack has advantage, which hits you, and it's a crit. So you lose two death saving throws. That ends Raishan's turn. Scanlan, death saving throw.
Oh my god.
3.
The breath escapes Scanlan's lungs, the smile across his face as life leaves his form.
This time I died with a bad joke and piss all over me.
Turn, Pike is up.
Pike. She's gonna stand up, and if she uses her sprinter's boots, can she run over to Scanlan and cast Revivify?
Go ahead and roll a d20 and add her wisdom modifier. Yeah, so 20 plus 5.
9.
Okay.
What?
So the Revivify fails, reaches out.
God fucking!
It doesn't hit.
Damn it!
Are we all here then?
Grog!
Scanlan's down.
I take off running for Vax.
Okay, as you turn around the corner, and you see Vax holding the still body of Scanlan just dangling out of his arms.
No. No! No! Fix him! Fix him!
It's not a rocket. You're a child.
Well, somebody do something.
We have to take him home.
We have to get him out of here.
Well, we've got all these people with magic. You've all got magic spells. You just brought him back. Fix him.
Pike looks at
get him to the castle.
Okay, sorry. Right? No, should we get him to the castle or the Raven Queen's temple?
The temple of the Raven.
Go to the Raven.
Okay, to the temple. To the temple.
Scry, find his daughter. Scry on his daughter.
You're pulled once more into what looks to be a tavern room. And there you see a makeshift band of very terrible performers playing. And on the back table you see Kaylee with half a flagon of ale sitting there, a dagger on the table, just staring and just giving those performers shit. She's like,
yeah, she's
you don't
like,
fucking suck, you know that?
She's a primal.
Who can send me there? I'll go.
I'll lord.
Kind of get you a little aside.
I'm probably coming back down now from the castle with the stone.
I can. I'm like, what? Can his sister do something or his daughter? Why the urgency? I mean,
because it's the only thing I can think of that could really drag him back from wherever he is. That's my thought. Not everything cuts through. You need to find the right thing to cut through, and I think this might be it.
And as each finger hits a point, you see him connect the thread, and as he connects the thread, both of you blink out, appear in the middle of this busy cobblestone street now. You could hear what sounds like raucous laughter and shouting in the distance, asking to where the different, where the worst performers you've seen perform in this town. And everyone keeps pointing you to this one place that's, it's pretty bad. And there you see, kind of half slumped over in the corner at the table, you see Kaylee just ready to pass out at the end.
Kaylee!
What do you want from me?
Smack her across the cheek.
You tit!
She grabs the dagger and like grabs you by the front
Darling,
of the shirt.
Darling, your brings father, Scanlan. Tell
Why,
me you're sober.
I remember you.
Are you sober?
I'm never sober.
Oh, fuck.
What's the...
Your father's hurt.
I don't want to deal with him right now. Like, tell him! Look.
Kaylee! And I pick her up and bring her up to my eye level.
I will kick your ass. Right now, if you keep treating me like this...
Your father... He died. But there's a chance we can bring him back. If you're willing to help.
How'd he die?
And she's still being held up, reaches over and grabs her tankard. Her feet still dangling.
Defending everyone. Saving the fucking land, can you believe it?
Who wouldn't want a death like that?
He died with piss all over him.
That sounds like my father.
Will you go?
And
Will you
what?
Go help Kaylee?
And help what?
I set her on the table, so we're still at level. Look, I know a little bit about having a father who wasn't around, right? Take it from me. It's not worth it. It's not worth harboring this hatred in your heart. If you can find it in yourself to forgive him, you'll live a much happier life.
She kind of looks at you for a second. You can see her kind of frustrated, piss-off facade drops a little and her eyes kind of sink below.
I really don't know what you think I can do, but, I mean, the very least I'd like to see his body before it's interred.
I pull out the stone and I put it in her hand. Concentrate on him. It'll bring you to him, I swear.
Nothing but strangeness surrounds you folks every time I cross paths with you, it seems.
Please, Kaylee.
I'll take my drink.
You can take whatever you want. Just promise me you'll try.
She kind of holds the stone for a second, looks at it. Kind of squints and eyeing it.
Listen, if you're trying to hit the piss out of me,
and her form just vanishes. Percy, as you hold the other end of the gate stone, you feel it begin to glow and warm in your hand. And you instinctually take a step back as within a bright flash, you watch as Kaylee stands there now at near the entranceway to the Raven Queen's temple, holding the other gate stone.
Right,
Good to see all of you. So, is it true?
Yes. He's inside.
Let me see the bastard. And she kind of pushes past and muscles through. Watches Kaylie steps up to the edge and kind of gets up onto the top of the central altar and kind of stands over quietly, looking down at Scanlan's cold body. He made me a promise.
I know.
You made me a promise! And she kind of leans forward, kneels down, and just slaps them across the face. Just, you made me a promise. And she gets up and kind of wipes her nose a bit and hops off and just storms.
I run after her. Wait!
What?
Listen, I know how angry you are. But we need you here today. So he can at least have more of a chance to be the father that you've always wanted him to be.
Those days have passed, I'm afraid.
You have no idea how much he loves you.
Oh, he's loved a lot of girls in his days. That I'm certain.
That may be true, but not as much as you.
Well, get on with it then. I figure at the very least we can go about our business when this is over. Clear conscience and all that. How much time you need?
As long as it takes.
Well, have we time for a drink?
Yes.
I'm gonna get a drink.
And she just kind of walks back into Whitestone. You finish preparations. Kaylie hasn't returned at that moment. About 10 minutes more pass, and you hear small footsteps begin to make their way to the outside of the temple. They're stepping through a little wobbly, but a stoic, stone-faced Kaylie.
All right, let's get it over with.
You can just smell the alcohol.
So do your thing.
Hold on. Look at me.
She turns around and looks up at you as she is practically just past your thigh.
That's so funny, I'd never realized it before. You look so much like him.
Well, be careful, I'm at the right height to be juggling you.
I'd expect no less.
I guess we'll go ahead and get started. Here lies Scanlan the Bard, a gnome who sang soft but died hard. To anyone who hears us, both far and wide, bring us back our dirty friend at least one more time. He may not be tall or brute or rough. He may be little, but his heart is buff. We are a party, and every party needs a clown. Without our friend to rein us in, we'll burn down your whole fucking town. You see, I love this gnome very much. He's small like me, but he's touched. He's raided and slain. He's pooped while he sang. But if he's gone forever, I won't be the same. Now that he's learned he's a dad, the journey that all of us had cannot be in vain, will not be in waste. Please, Scanlan, open your eyes and see your daughter's face.
As you finish the poem you'd wrote and step back, the second of the three portions of the circle comes aglow. At this point, as you step back, there's a flash of movement at the edge of the altar. And with a double clack of her shoes, you watch Kaylie land her flip onto the top of the altar, stand up straight, wobble for a second and catch her. She pulls out her fiddle.
Wait. I just take her wrist. It's no small thing to have a father who loves you. And I cast Lay on Hands and clear her mind of the alcohol.
She closes her eyes, and for the first time since she arrived, you watch as the tears that she had kept at bay blink down her cheek, finally, and begins to play a beautiful, soft, sad violin piece that begins to swell faster and faster and faster and transition from a mournful piece of remembrance into a lively, jovial fiddle piece. The music begins to pick up and she begins to dance, her feet clacking across the top of the altar. She brings it to a giant crescendo and finishes with a flourish, the bow. She puts her head up and you see the tears shoot down her face, no smile, just a stoned expression, and she gives a bow. The third and final portion of the ritual begins to swell. The glyphs fade and go cold. The light of the room descends. A moment passes. Another moment passes. And eyes still closed, he watches a small smile curls across Galen's face. And his chest rises and falls and rises and falls. Kaylee walks up. Wipe that smile off your face. We're gonna have a talk, and slaps his face the other way. Jumps off the altar, slams out the two doors, the front, and kind of staggers out of the temple.
So you guys find your way upwards to Scanlan's room. The door's partially ajar. On the inside, you see Kaylee is actually asleep. She's sitting on a stool next to the bed, and she is, her head's kind of down, and she's very lightly snoring. And there in the bed, as you left him, is Scanlan.
How you doing, Kaylee?
She looks groggy and slightly hungover, and is like, all right. He isn't really doing nothing. And she kind of smacks him on the side of the face and wipes some of the pudding off. You hear, just ever so faintly, as you kind of are coming out of your stupor, you hear what sounds like voices muffled. And it comes to it, you hear, it sounds like grog. And then it sounds like Kaylee. And then something hits you in the cheek and you feel a slight tinge of pain, like a flick. But your eyes begin to blink and you guys watch as Scanlan begins to stir.
Hey, nice to see you.
Hello.
You guys hear Scanlan
Hello.
Talking.
Let's go.
Scanlan!
Hi.
Hey, buddy.
Welcome back.
How are you feeling?
Where am I?
You missed all the fun.
What's going on? Why am I like this? Where am I?
You don't remember?
No. Is the dragon alive?
No, you killed it. And then we all celebrated and you had a big orgy.
Yeah, you proposed to this woman downstairs and this is your bachelor party.
Yeah, you clearly have some very intense dreams, Scanlan.
I feel like you're fucking with me.
And you hear Kaylee's voice to the left. He goes,
oh, you think that? Probably very true.
What are you doing here?
Well, apparently, your friends brought me along to make sure that you woke up nice and right.
They brought you here?
Aye.
And the dragon is very dead. Very, very dead.
But you are not. And that's very important.
Kaylee, could you excuse us a moment?
Aye, but don't take too long. I've got mine to speak to you in a minute.
She just kind of storms past and pushes a little gnome figure kind of pushing through the crowd of Vox Machina and out of the room.
I'm sorry I fell again. Can someone answer me one thing, though? Who got Kaylee? Who brought Kaylee here?
Bex did.
Down on the bed with you. But it just seemed like the logical thing to do, dear.
Why the fuck would you do that?
Right. Well, because you said
I promised her I wasn't going to die, and you showed her my dead body. You thought that was a good idea?
What, you'd rather she just discover it on her own?
No, I'd rather she never know.
Scanlan. She came here. She helped bring you back. You know what that means, right?
Yes, I do, unfortunately.
You think it's bad that she cares about you?
I think it's bad that she thinks that I'm an oath breaker. that I am weak, that I failed in my promise to her.
Scanlan.
That everything she thought of me when she found me is confirmed now, that I can't be trusted and I can't protect her.
All your daughter knows is that you stood against great evil, overtaking an entire continent.
She also knows that I fell, and that my friends thought it would be funny to put me in a fucking nightgown and spread pudding all over me.
That was me.
And bring my lifeless body and show her how weak her father is. That's what she saw. I made a promise and I broke it, and you proved it to her. And I wish you hadn't meddled in my affairs. I don't have many things that I care about, and I don't have anything that cares about me.
That's a lie.
That is bullshit.
It's definitely
full
untrue.
Bullshit.
What? You think you care about me?
Yeah. Yes, asshole, yes.
Yes, I'm sorry, you're right. You like me because I make jokes and I play songs and I give you a warm place to stay at night and I feed you fucking chicken and I heal you in battle. But you don't really care about me, come on. Let's be honest with each other. You don't really give a shit about
me. I've changed my outlook on life because of you. What the fuck are you talking about?
We traveled into the fucking Nine Hells to get Pike a suit of armor. We went and battled a city of vampires so Percy could feel good about his name. We fought Goliaths for Grog. We've traveled across planes of existence so you could fix your fucking daddy issues. But you've never done anything for me. Ever. You've never risked anything. You don't know me. You don't know anything about me. What's my mother's name? What's her name? Easy question. Died in front of me. Killed by a goblin. Biggest part of my life. What's her name? It's fine. I'm just a little hungover from being dead. And I just have been thinking for a while that, you know, Grog has Pike. Vax has Keyleth. Percy has Vex. But Scanlan has no one. And I had one chance at one real relationship with my daughter. And I feel like you gone and fucked it up too. Because you don't really know me and you don't really know what my relationship is with her or what I promised her or anything really. And it's fine. When I met you all, I was just a funny little man playing songs. And that's all I'll ever really be. And that's okay, because I can take care of myself.
Nobody knew that any of this was going on. How many times have we asked you if you're all right and you just laugh and joke? We can't help you if you don't tell us what's going on.
I don't need your help.
Well, apparently you do, darling.
Well, I don't like that very much at all.
Well, get used to it. No. Nobody likes needing someone.
I thought you were the only one who had everything figured out.
I did too.
Well, then I must be a very good liar.
You are.
You are.
Scanlan. Do you wish we wouldn't have brought you back? Should we not have done that?
I just wish you wouldn't have brought her into this.
Scanlan,
I had one shot with her, and now how will I ever show her that I can be trusted? How will I ever show her that I can protect her?
Well, maybe you should fucking talk to her.
Yeah, you think you are a better father than most of us have ever had.
You're right, I should talk to her.
You should.
I should.
Don't treat her like a fucking sacred object. Treat her like a daughter,
Fine.
Scanlan.
You're right. I will. I'll talk to her. Listen, I don't know what adventure we're going on next, but I think you should go without me. Vex is right, I should talk to her. I should be here for her. I don't know why I wasn't with her in the first place. I didn't need to go with you to kill the dragons. I should have just been with her in the first place. I was probably just scared to. I should just be her father. And stay.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah. No, I will not go whoring with you one more time.
No, I was going to ask you what your mother's name is.
Miss Juniper.
I'm sorry, I didn't know that.
Thank you for asking.
I'm glad you're back. Whatever you want to do now that you are, it's up to you, mate.
We have survived a fucking hellscape, all of us.
I didn't.
You are standing before me, talking to me. You did.
I did not. I died
twice. That's fucking semantics.
In a row.
Shorthalt. You've been brought back, you're standing here. Your daughter is there and needs you.
I'm being kept alive by some fucked up weird magic. Before I met you people, I would have never... The worst I would have gotten in is a bar fight. And I would have won, because I would have been a liar and a cheater. And now I didn't help you, any of you in the last fight. I didn't do anything. The fight before that, I didn't do anything.
What about the 30
useless.
Before that?
No, you're not.
No, I'm out of my league. I'm out of my league. Listen, it was fun. It's fun. It really has been fun to travel with six legends.
We would be dead, all of us, if it weren't for you. You are in a pity party right now, and I know you're hurting, and I'm sorry you're hurting, and I love you. But you are lying to yourself that you've been of no use to us. You are lying to yourself. If you want to retire, if you want to go off with your daughter, that's fucking wonderful. I encourage you to do it. But don't lie to yourself.
Well, that's just it. I'm a really good liar.
Hey, guys. We're friends, right? Are we friends?
Worse. Family. And for fuck's sake, sir, I will say I died in that fight, too. And let me tell you something. Is whatever lie you were trying to feed your daughter out there about the man she thought you might be, that you just thought you could tell her and then she would walk away and never actually meet you or get to know you, so that maybe she would never see what a shit you can be. That fucking girl out there is a shit too. She's a miserable, lying shit.
Mm-hmm.
And for fuck's sake, the thing that brought her back here was the things about you that you don't like about yourself, and don't think that they don't count either. You're a shitty person, we know! That's not the fucking point. You are worthwhile, there's a reason we just nearly went mad trying to bring you back. It was not pity, and we didn't bring here, we brought her here so that maybe she would snap you out of wherever the fuck you were going to. Get to know her and stop making false promises that you can protect her and you'll always be there, because you can't and you won't. I'm out.
Okay, as you push the door open, it's still partially ajar, and as you push it open, leaning against the wall just by the door is Kaylie, and you can see she has tears streaming down her face. Turns into the room and just walks past everyone and grabs her bag off the ground, slings it over her shoulder, grabs her violin case. So you coming?
Yeah.
Grab your things. I'll be waiting for you downstairs. And she walks out.
Really? Just like that?
I have to.
Where are you gonna go? What are you gonna do?
I'm just gonna be a Shorthalt for a while. And I'm just gonna figure out what that means. It's great being part of a team, but you gotta know who you are first. So I gotta go figure that out. And I gotta go figure out what she is too. I know you'll be fine, because you all have each other. I love you all. I even love Percy. And I'll go with Kaylee.
Can you scry?
Me?
Yeah. See where he is, what's he doing?
I
call it the scrying eye.
He's walking through the parchwood forest that surrounds Whitestone. He is on the path south. Him and to his left is Kaylee, and they're both with their sacks over their shoulders, and they're just hiking through the forest. They're, at the moment, not talking, but they're both slightly smiling, just kind of enjoying the journey and the company.